Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem from the Putnam exam in 1993. To answer this, you'll need to know the Leibniz formula for pi. Pause the video if you want to give this problem a go, and when you're ready, we'll go for the solution. To start this problem, we'll consider the unit square with area 1, because then we can represent all xy pairs inside this shape. And asking when does x over y round to an even is the same thing as asking when does y over x round to an even by symmetry. And so we can consider the equation y equals mx, since this will pass all points inside our plane. We want to know when does y over x round to some even, which is the same thing as asking when is the gradient going to round to 0, 2, 4, and so on. And if we start by considering the equation y equals a half x, then all points inside this triangle are such that y over x rounds to 0. So therefore we can say the probability of this occurring is the same as the area of this triangle, which is just 1/4. And asking when does y over x round to 2 will occur when our gradient lies between 2.5 and 1.5. So we can represent it as the following triangle. And the probability of this occurring is the area of this triangle. We can find the area of this triangle by using the half base times height. So knowing that the height of this triangle is 1, and its base will be 1 over 1.5 minus 1 over 2.5. That's because they both lie on the line y equals 1. So therefore, the area of this triangle and the probability that y over x rounds to 2 will be 1/2 multiplied by 1 over 1.5 minus 1 over 2.5. And if we do the same thing again and consider when is y over x going to round to 4, then this is considering when m lies between 4.5 and 3.5. And so we can represent this as another triangle and again ask what is the area of that. So the area of that triangle and the probability that it will round to 4 will be 1/2 times 1 over 3.5 minus 1 over 4.5. And now hopefully you can start to see the pattern. So considering when does y over x round to become 6, this will occur when the area of our triangle is 1/2 multiplied by 1 over 5.5 minus 1 over 6.5. And so we can represent the probability as the sum of these infinitely many triangles. So we have the following, and we can continue simplifying this down. So this becomes 1/4 plus 1/2. And then this will be 2/3 minus 2/5 plus 2/7 minus 2/9. And by taking out a factor of 2 from our infinite sum, this becomes 1/4 plus 1/3 minus 1/5 plus 1/7 minus 1/9, and so on. At this stage, we can use our Leibniz formula because we can realize that this part of our series is equal to 1 minus pi over 4. And therefore, 1/4 plus that becomes 5 over 4 minus pi over 4. And so this is our probability, which is about 0.46.